a world that has an 8-day week. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and someday. Someday I will run the marathon. Someday I will quit the stupid job and start my business. Someday I will spend more time with my children. Someday I will travel to see the northern lights. Someday I will write a book. Someday I will marry the woman of my dreams. Someday, one day, when, if. These are all variations of this syndrome, the someday syndrome. And that is what we will talk about in this episode. Hi, I'm Sheila, and this is Lumiere 24, Light On. I heard a talk by Dr. Miles Monroe, where he says that the richest place in the world is not the oil-producing countries or the first world nations. The richest place in the world is the cemetery. There lies the books that were never written, songs that were never sung, paintings that never saw the light of the day, and businesses that never opened. We walk around thinking we are immortal, or that death is something that is also on the someday list. Not so. The only thing guaranteed in life is death, and it can be the very next minute, the very next day, or after 40 years, but dead we all will be. And subconsciously, we know that, yet our some days stay some days without a single action taken. Do you know why? It's not what you think. It's not because you're a lazy person. It's not because it's someone else's fault. And it's not because you honestly will get to it later. There are three things which stop you: disinterest, inertia, and fear. Those are the only reasons why people say, I'll get around to doing it someday. And if you can overcome these three blocks, you'll never say that again. Let me say it again: disinterest, inertia, and fear. Maybe you're not doing something because in reality, it doesn't fit in with who you are and the expectations that are likely to come along with it, and go find something that suits you better. My cousin has a whiteboard filled with stuff like write a book, learn Japanese, run a marathon, learn to cook, read a book a day. And when we looked at her list, she realized that cooking is not her forte. Marathon is not her thing. She's an indoor type. And she didn't really want to write a book. That was an expectation because her uncle was a writer, her dad's a writer, and her cousins, including me, are writers. The moment you let go of other people's dreams, you will find your own. Inertia, on the other hand, is the lack of willpower to get things done. It's not that you don't know what to do. And mostly, it has to do with the environment that you put yourself in. Remember, your environment is stronger than your willpower. Let me say that again because it's so important. Your environment is stronger than your willpower. If you stay in an environment where everyone is committed to living a life of passion and purpose, so will you. If you run with 9 losers, bet you anything that you will soon be the 10th loser. Let's say your New Year resolution is to get fit. But if all of your friends keep eating fried stuff, don't exercise, and are overweight, how motivated will you be to retain a healthy lifestyle? That's how it is. Your environment will influence you. So you have to be in the right environment. And the third biggest showstopper, fear. Right from school, we have been taught to conform and fit in. The seed of conformity is sowed in schools, where we are expected to walk alike, talk alike, dress alike, and even a slightest difference is frowned upon. And that's where the peer influence starts, where you adopt a particular type of behavior, dress, or attitude in order to be accepted as a part of a group of your equals. And families and societies are formed using this. We feel uncomfortable being different. We teach our children to be the same. And the fear that I'm talking about, this is not about fighting the world war or taking on a tiger. It's a fear of standing up for things we believe in that are important to us, and that most of the time keeps people stuck. We let the words should and have to rule our lives. You should study. you should become an engineer, you should get married, have children, retire, and then pursue your dreams. We live our lives filled with stuff instead of achievements. We live on autopilot without making active, conscious choices. Okay, so yeah, you're infected in some way. What next? So, maybe I have just the right tool for you in Sheila's toolbox. This one is called the WIT technique, and I use it frequently with all my clients. When my clients come to me with their list of goals to be achieved, big and small, and then they're so overwhelmed and overworked and they don't know where to start, I show them the simple technique. Look at what you have on your someday list and ask, am I interested or am I committed? Let's say you want to quit your job and do what you really love. You want to make films. Ask, am I interested or am I committed? If you're just interested, you will do it when it's convenient. When the Pluto is aligned with Jupiter, or after that next raise, or after you finish checking your WhatsApp notifications, forwarding meaningless jokes and videos, watching babies laughing, cats dancing on YouTube, stalking your ex on social media, scrolling through other people's lives, being foolishly righteous over things that will never concern you, and before you know it, 2 or 3 hours have gone, or 2 years of your life have gone by, and now your someday moves a little further away. And there you see what has happened. One of my mentors taught me this. He said, if you have to do one new thing in your life, you have to give up one thing that's not moving you towards your goal. Whether it's watching your TV show, an afternoon siesta, your water cooler gossip, your social media crawls, whatever. And ask, am I interested or am I committed? If you're committed, you will do whatever it takes. So tell me, what have you been putting off until someday that you should be doing today? Write in the comment box below. I would love to hear from you. Let's talk. And remember the 3-word mantra, like, share, subscribe. Let's spread the light, folks.